So, welcome everybody, welcome ladies and gentlemen, students, participants of our forum and other guests. Let me introduce myself. My name is Igor Tkachenko. I am the chairman of Students Forum Secretariat of Russia-Africa What is Next Forum. And today we have a great pleasure to deliver the conversation with Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of the Republic of South Sudan to the Russian Federation, His Excellency Chol Tong Mayay. Thank you, Your Excellency, and I'd like to express again my highest appreciation for giving us the chance to take an interview with you and for your friendly welcome. And to begin with, Your Excellency, could you tell us just a few words about the history of your country?
Thank you very much for this opportunity for the Youth Forum. It's my pleasure to be in this forum and to host me at this moment. South Sudan is exactly 9 years last July, 9th July. It got its independence 2011 from the whole Sudan. So we're part of the Republic of Sudan. South Sudan has struggled, waging war against the several regimes in Khartoum till 2005, when a comprehensive peace agreement was signed. And that peace agreement, South Sudan was granted a pre-interim period of 6 years, in which, after the end of 6 years, they will have a self-determination through a referendum. So a referendum was conducted in 2011, in which 98% voted for suppression. Because what was put there is that it's either South to separate or to be part of Sudan under a new confederation arrangement. But the South Sudanese prepared the option of seceding from the northern part. So we became an independent country by 9th July 2011. And we are recognized by UN and older countries, including Russia, recognized the independent Republic of South Sudan. South Sudan is a landlocked country, is bordering to the North Sudan, to the East Ethiopia, to the South is Uganda, Southwest is Kenya, and to the West, Democratic Republic of Congo and Central Africa Republic. So that is the location of the Republic of South Sudan. Regionally, we are part of the East African Community, the regional organization, and also part of the IGAD countries. So that briefly about South Sudan. The population is roughly about 10 million, according to the last census, which was conducted in 2010.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. And Your Excellency, my next question is regarded to the previous one, related to the previous one. But I'd like to ask, as we know, South Sudan is a rather young country, is the youngest country in the world. So do you face any problems in that regard?
Yeah, of course, like any young person, one has to face a lot of problems of growth. Yes, South Sudan became an independent 2011, and of course has faced some issues, including the economic problems. As you know, the world has been in such economic issues. Like in 2008, there was that economic recession worldwide, and 3 years we got our independence. Of course, issues to do with the nation building are always issues to any country, particularly a new established country, faces. Unfortunately, that we landed into a war in 2013, 3 years after our independence. We had a civil war among ourselves, and that continued up to 2018 when a peace agreement is formed. So we have these issues of peace building and particularly the nation building. I can put it broadly, issues of nation building are really issues, because we've got independent and the population is expecting a lot from us, and our country has been in war for since Sudan got its independence in 1956. We had been in war for over 30 years. You can see from all the independent years, there has never been a development in South Sudan in terms of infrastructure. There's total absence of infrastructure, and these are the challenges of the new state. We will have challenges of putting infrastructure in place and developing the country. These are the challenges now the country is facing.
Okay, thank you. And also, Your Excellency, could you inform us about the current state of your bilateral relations with Sudan?
Yeah, currently we have the country has a very good relations. After independence, our relations have been a bit of turbulence in our relations after the independence, and particularly with the former regime of Omar al-Bashir. But before even Bashir was ousted, the relations start normalization between the two countries. So now there are very good relations between the South and Khartoum. Even the peace agreement between the warring parties in the North was just signed this year in Juba. Our country decided that particularly the President of the Republic, Salva Kiir, mediated a peace agreement between the opposition to the Khartoum government to conclude peace, and that peace was recently signed. Likewise, in 2018, the peace between the opposition and the government in South Sudan was signed in Khartoum. So there are now very good cordial relations between the two countries.
Thank you. And in addition to my previous question, could you please also tell us about South Sudan relations with other neighboring countries, such as Ethiopia or Central African Republic, for example?
Yeah, with the other neighboring countries, of course, as I said before, that South Sudan is a member of the regional bloc, that is East African bloc, and IGAD is intergovernmental development organization, which include Ethiopia, Sudan, South Sudan, Djibouti, Somalia, Eritrea. Ethiopia, they have very cordial relations with South Sudan, and this goes back historically. We have been having such good cordial relations, and they stood with us during the struggle. So we have that very friendly relation. The same thing with Uganda, very friendly relations, also with Kenya. As you know, South Sudan is a landlocked. For us to get our imports or export is through Mombasa, that is through Kenya. So that Kenya is a very strategic to South Sudan for its economic activities. With the Central African Republic, there is not that so much close relations. As you know, Central African Republic has been in really in troubles. The government has not been in place there, as you know. So there are not that very close relations between South Sudan and Central African Republic.
Mm-hmm. And moving on, could you also inform us about the history of the development of Russia and South Sudan relations?
South was part of the of Sudan. If at all, if there was any, were any relations, these were relations between Sudan and the then Soviet Union, USSR, where South Sudan benefited a bit from some scholarships which were awarded to Sudan by then, and also there were some factories. I remember there were some factories which were built by the Soviet in some of the places in South Sudan. But after the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, as you know, that Russia has never been really so active in Africa, given the, its own internal issues when Russia was really trying to fix itself. After the independence, Russia is one of the first countries which has recognized the Republic of South Sudan as an independent country. And immediately in 2012, they established bilateral relations, and the embassy was recovered by non-resident ambassador based in Uganda. There has been some bilateral relations and interactions between the two countries, particularly in the UN Security Council. In this multilateral organization, Russia has stood with South Sudan in most of the issues raised against South Sudan, like sanction in the UN Security Council. Russia several times stood with South Sudan, protecting South Sudan not to be sanctioned. So there is that cooperation at the multilateral levels. On bilateral, of course, there are a lot of engagement now going on. There has been some visits by the senior officials from the government of the Republic of South Sudan from that time up to now. Even this year, in January, the Minister of Foreign Affairs was here. Last year in St. Petersburg, the Economic Forum, the Vice President was invited and attended the Economic Forum in St. Petersburg. And most of the forum, like Energy Week in Russia, the Minister of Petroleum used to attend. And there are so many, memorandum of understanding on economic cooperation, which are already being concluded between Russia and South Sudan.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Your Excellency. And how you assess the current state of these relations, and what prospects could you point out?
Yeah, the prospect is good. I think we are moving to really consolidating our bilateral relations. As I said during the Russia-Africa summit, the two ministers of foreign affairs of Russia and South Sudan signed a memorandum of understanding, a memorandum of cooperation between the two ministries, which is really very good development. And one of the largest companies here, Rus Geologia, signed a memorandum of understanding with the Minister of Mining for this Rus Geologia to go and do some mining and also mapping of natural resources in South Sudan. Likewise, Rosneft is also interested, and Zurvichneft. So I'm seeing that the prospect of our relations, bilateral relations between the Republic of South Sudan and Russia are really moving toward a positive outcome, and it is because of coronavirus. The deputy minister and special envoy, the President Putin, Mikhail Bogdanov, should have visited South Sudan this year, but because of coronavirus, has never made it possible for him to visit. And there were a lot of activities which were supposed to happen. David Ruth Geloge was also supposed to go to South Sudan, and I'm sure some contracts would have been finalized by this time. But because coronavirus, as you know, year 2020 has become a dead year. No activities have really taken place.
Yes, so Your Excellency, our students also are interested to know what projects are currently being implemented in Russia related to the relations with South Sudan.
Yeah, as I said before, because these are the projects which are in the pipeline, there are no really concrete projects now being implemented. These are the projects which are already now to be implemented soon, and I'm sure if the coronavirus is going to come to an end in 2021, then a lot of activities will really happen. At the level of businesses, because there is one small company there now in South Sudan which is building a refinery, a small refinery. I think that is the only what is going on. But the bigger issues, the bigger, I mean, projects will come in, and this is what we have been working on. As I've been here, I've really engaged with all the, even the Chamber of Commerce had a very good engagement with them. And this year there was supposed to be a sort of a conference where Chamber of Commerce was supposed to host the business community, Chamber of Commerce, South Sudan business community of South Sudan, to come and make a presentation to the Russian business communities of the opportunities available in the Republic of South Sudan. Say that the business community here is oriented, because the Russian business community, the small and larger scale businesses, they don't really know what are the opportunities available there. And this was what was agreed, but because of the COVID, this one didn't happen. And of course, we are postponing for next year. And I think that is one of the best opportunities where the business opportunity, the business community here will be in picture, and will now try to move to the Republic of South Sudan.
Thank you. And we are moving on to the last question. And Your Excellency, could you please tell us about the development of the sphere of tourism in your country before the pandemic? Was it safety enough to traveling to South Sudan?
Yeah, in fact, this is one of the best opportunities where Russia and South Sudan could really come into terms. And South Sudan has a good potential tourist sites which could really attract, we can say, tourist attraction sites. But because of our war 2013, that is disrupted the tourism. You see, and now when the peace was signed 2018, situation now was stabilizing, and now again came the coronavirus. So the tourism attraction sites are there, and are also areas we would like the Russians to come in. As you may be aware of Kenya, National Park, they are bordering. Most of the animals which are sometimes shown in Kenyan Park are animals migrating from South Sudan. See, they do migrate from South Sudan, particularly when there is war. So they migrate to Kenya side. Mm-hmm. You see, so we have the potential for tourism, which is not that highly devolved, but which will be devolved as peace is implemented, as now we are already implementing the peace agreement, and situation now is stable. And a bit of infrastructure also to be in place, because you need an infrastructure to build an infrastructure like roads, some accommodation places for tourists, those places, and I think these are some works to be done. So I'm sure in 2 years to 3 years time, tourism is going to pick up in South Sudan.
So thank you. I hope that all our subscribers now have intentions to visit your beautiful country. And we are coming to the end of our interview. So thank you, Your Excellency, and thank you, dear guests and subscribers.